Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over how to create a histogram in Microsoft Excel. In case you are wondering what a histogram is, it is a graph that looks like this. In our example, we are going to take an age, and every age on here is going to fall into a bracket. So if you look down here, you can see that there's a less than 18 bracket, an 18 to 45, a 45 to 72, and a 72 to 99. And the number up here tells you how many instances there are of data results in that age range. Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that. So if I start with my spreadsheet here, and I don't even have the histogram on here, it's pretty easy to get the histogram created. First, I'm going to highlight my data set by clicking on A1, holding down the left mouse button, dragging over to B1, and then just dragging down to the end of my data. Next, I'm going to go up here to Insert, and here's a whole bunch of different charts. And right here, under Insert Statistical Chart, I'm going to pick the first histogram. And I can see that Excel has already put a histogram for all of my data right here. So what does this histogram tell me? Well, first of all, it tells me that my data has been separated into four different groups. The 1 to 28 range, 28 to 55, 55 to 82, and 82 to 109.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
But the first thing that might be really nice to add to our graph would be some data labels at the top so that I know how many are in each bin. I mean, I can read the graph and tell that 17 is in here and 15 is in here and 13 is in here, etc. But let's make that a little bit easier. So I can right click on the chart and go to add data labels. And now I can see the number in each one of these bins at the top. What if I wanted more bins than just the four that came by default? Well, if I click once to select all of the bins, you'll notice that it's selected if it has a rectangle around it. And then I double click, I will be brought up with Format Access. And down here, I can have a number of bins. And instead of that being four, let's change that to 8 and hit Enter. And I can see I now have 8 bins, and the numbers at the top have changed because the data has been spread out and the bins have become thinner. But there is one issue. If I look at the bins down here, I can now see that there's decimals being incorporated here. So if I select number, if I go down here and instead of selecting general, I select number, and then with decimal places, let's make that 0. See much clearer labels for age. Now there's a couple other things I can do. I can put a chart title in, so I can just click here, change that, and let's make this age histogram. And I can also click on my chart, go up here to add chart elements, and go to access titles, and put a primary horizontal, and go again and put the primary vertical. And I can double click on this, and I know that this one is age, and I can double click on this, and I know that this one is population. If I want my graph to be a little bit bigger, I can drag it over to the left, and I can just hover over this circle here till I get this double-sided arrow, and then I can click with my left mouse button and drag down here to the right, and now my graph is bigger. I can also select my graph and go up here to Add Chart Element and go to Gridlines, go to More Gridline Options, and say No Line. And once I click this, you will see that these horizontal lines will disappear. These are some of the options that you can change on your histogram once you create it. You can also check our blog entry for this lesson. I will include the link to that below in the YouTube description. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.